when other people catch a fish, they just catch a fish. But when Mike catches it, there are trumpets that blare and angels that sing. And, you know, everybody's got to sit down and gather around him and hold his hands and watch him carve it out.
That is another indication of Mike being Mike about himself.
Take one bite and just keep passing and we'll just...
Michael does like to be in the limelight. I don't think there's any doubt about that.
I mean, one of my family mottos is, are you going to watch the news today or make the news? And...
He orchestrated a Ponzi scheme and stole just over $30,000. As investigators searched his computer, they found child pornography.
I'm going to find something that's alive that we are going to kill.
I am very, very determined to get a pig.
I'm going to go catch pigs. And he takes our knife and our rope. That's classic Mike. He's an idiot.
The judge told Scoop and she gave him a harsh sentence because of his hypocrisy. She said he didn't take responsibility for the crimes and instead tried to paint himself as a do-gooder, the founder of the Michael Scoopin Ministries.
Thanks for that.
Amen.
Amen.
Mike thanked God for making him the leader of the tribe. I don't know when he was anointed, but apparently my back was turned at that moment.
Not accident prone. You know, it's just the way that I go through life. Act first, think second.
Today, an Oakland County Circuit Court judge told Michael Scoopin he's now going to have to survive 1 to 4 years in prison.
This is the way chickens eat every day, right?
He thinks it cooks in your body because it's pretty close to 100 degrees. So Mike makes horrible decisions. He's the most useless player that's ever been returned to Survivor, and he needs to go home.
My number one. My number one.
I have 7 kids. Married.
Seven kids and married.
Yeah, married.
What's the range in age?
College, high school, middle school, elementary. I never stopped having them.
Okay. Yeah.
In your shirt.
Scoopin asked the judge for mercy for the sake of his children before learning his sentence for charges of larceny and possessing child pornography. The judge told him he exploited not only the children in the pictures he possessed, but his own children.
Part of your defense was casting suspicion on your 17-year-old stepchild.
Mike is really annoying.
Sorry. Because
you're an idiot. That's why you're gonna lose $1 million.
I do not want to see Silas win the $1 million. I can see any of the other three win the $1 million. I don't want him winning the $1 million. I don't trust him at all. There's something up there. I'm not even sure of his name. There's just something not quite right.
The local I team uncovered new information about the sexual assault accusations against former Survivor contestant Silas Gaither. The Germantown actor was arrested on rape and aggravated assault charges this week.
The most infamous of all survivors. Johnny Fairplay, who already looks intoxicated.
Mike Gravelier's not here for a reason. He's on the ramp.
Love the hat, love the hat.
Oh, mother.
Yao Ming tackles my head into the side of the boat.
Sorry.
You can talk to me, Yao Ming.
I'm sorry. Yeah.
Trust me, Yao Ming is not America's hero like you think he is. Even Johnny Fairplay wouldn't tackle someone's head into the side of a boat for an immunity idol.
Johnny Fairplay, the tribe has spoken. Happy to go.
Can I get a hug? You be nice to those guys. Bye, guys.
One more hug, just one more. I need one more hug. Just to get me through the day. I'm just so out of it, James.
It's okay.
Is it?
Everybody has their day.
I don't know what it is, but I'm just downward spiraling and I can't take another minute. I can't. I can't. I know it's sunny, it's beautiful, it's like, ooh, but I can't. I can't be here one more minute. I can't take it. I just want you guys to be okay and not hate me for it. I just can't take it one more minute. I can't. I want them to come and get a boat and pick me up and take me away. I can't do this anymore. I can't. I've tried so hard.
I know, sweetie. I know.
I've tried so hard.
Catherine Hoffman.
Kathy just really got in her head today. Like, everything just compiled and built up one upon another, and she's just severely depressed.
I need somebody to be able to help me to the final two. So I would have to take somebody like Natalie with me, because she's gonna ride my coattails the whole way. She's too stupid to do it by herself. She needs me. So I could stand up there and say, she followed my coattails this whole way. She rode me like a horse. I would think my best partner out here would be Natalie.
You see, Natalie is my ticket to get rid of both Jason and Mick. So she can go pretty far in this game with me. Maybe all the way to the final two, because who better to take? There's no way she can beat me in boats. She followed and did everything I told her to do. She wouldn't even know how to talk. She might even say, oh, he's right, give it all to him. You know, she's so sweet, I love it.
I'm trying to keep Natalie because she's holding on my coattails.
Who better to take the final two than her? There's no way she can beat me in boats.
The winner of Survivor Samoa, Natalie.
She's weak in challenges. She's easy to beat for the vote. Sounds like somebody I want to take with me to the jury. You know why everybody wants to take you to the end?
Because I already won and they'll win against me.
Yeah.
But I don't care, I'll take the $100,000 because I knew I wasn't going to win again.
And no matter what, in any circumstances, I'm keeping Sandra. I think she might get Courtney's vote and that's it. So I'm going to use Sandra for me to win $1 million. She can't beat me.
I want you in the final three because I think I could beat you for the million.
All right.
Straight up.
I'll take the $100,000. You know how I feel.
It just makes sense to me.
If Sandra's with us, she instantly gets Amanda, Candace, and Courtney.
I don't think so.
Poverty wants me to get rid of Sandra because she can't even beat Sandra. She surely can't beat me, so she's trying to find out a way to possibly get second.
Best option for me is to take Jerry and Sandra. And that would be the best strategic move for me.
Your best strategic move?
Would be Jerry and Sandra.
No, because Sandra would win.
The winner of Survivor, Heroes vs. Villains, Sandra.
My mom's gonna kill me.
What?
Oh my gosh.
That's hilarious.
I think when it drinks too much, you guys.
I'm gonna go pee, I'll be right back.
The guys broke out the wine and they've been sucking down it for the last couple hours, and a couple of them are pretty tipsy right now. Definitely Todd and definitely Amanda aren't going to be feeling too well in the morning.
Todd is in serious trouble. He has hit rock bottom and he has reached out for a lifeline once again.
Survivor winner Todd returns.
Are you trying to drink yourself to death?
I'm still living it, but I don't want to.
He's having seizures.
He had 12 yesterday, 2 today. This young man is in dire, dire straits.
All new Dr. Phil.
I don't have snake wine because I don't drink.
We had snake wine
that
we had.
Almost had it out with him.
What you want?
Damn. Lazy.
It really pissed me off.
Almost to the point that I was ready to give him a kung fu chop.
My main goal out here, besides winning the game, is to know people that I would never know before. Like James, he's exotic. And Laurel, she stood out to me because where I'm from, it's mainly Caucasian. And I don't have a chance to have, you know, an African-American friend.
You're gonna wish you didn't, but you know it deep down.
Naoka seems like a high school girl. She's irrational and crazy, and she just seems like she's on her period all the time.
I'm a theology student.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I got my degree in women's ministries.
Really?
I don't want to be a pastor of men. I don't believe that that's the woman's role.
Yeah.
And Brandon and Frank.
Welcome to our role again.
Very interesting. Let the games begin.
Let the games.
Believe me, I did not pick Brandon. Brandon would be the last person on earth I would pick. I cringed because I saw everyone pairing up, and big old Tom got a big belly full on this one, you know, and
I better get away from it. Frank is a man. That disposition is about 80 years old, set in his way, and for them two to get together and go to that reward, I swear, if I was playing a dirty trick on him, I couldn't have thought of a better thing to do to Frank.
It's real simple.
have two kids from a previous relationship. Donnell's 10, Janelle is 7. I'm with Carmella now, Kayla with her, and now Gunner. You know, Kayla's 2, and Gunner's the new addition.
4 kids, holy Moses.
Now, are you and Gunner and Kayla's mom together permanently?
No, never been married. Yeah, he had some rough spots that we had to fix out. So we're just smoothing those out.
Yeah.
You know.
When I was brought up, if a girl was pregnant and wasn't married, you'd never even know it. I mean, they'd take her out of town or something. It was that bad, you know. The girl could have had an abortion. I'll agree with an abortion. But not having kids out of wedlock.
It's a huge responsibility.
Enough one for one child, family, much less two.
Yeah, one child is a huge responsibility, let alone two.
I don't agree with babies out of wedlock. That kind of garbage, you know. Half of the problem they got in this country today, there's no family life. And they're blaming the schools. It starts way before them kids go to school. They need a family. They need somebody beating them in the head.
All right, when we come back, this guy up in the corner wearing green today, Colton, one of the most controversial to ever play. We're going to talk about Colton and the bullying that went on along with Alicia.
Enjoy your last 2 days. You can quit or you can jump in that fire, whichever is more convenient for you.
That little munchkin is about to get knocked back to Oz.
I don't know why you don't like me, man.
Go kill yourself. You're ghetto trash. I don't want to be around you. He's a struggling stand-up comic. Like, get a real job.
I'm a Republican. I do not believe in handouts.
I did go to a private, like, all-white school, but I have, like, African-American people in my life.
Who?
My housekeeper.
I think there's a lot of aspects of Colton that are really fabulous. And I think I would have liked to see, I think, more of how it unraveled so that we could see everyone give him his due.
So his exit was a little early because...
Yes, exactly. I think that would have added a little more entertainment to what was already very entertaining about him.
Should he play again?
I'd watch that.
Thanks, Maya.
An unexpected shakeup gives rise to a supervillain.
That's it. I'm weaving blankets tomorrow. Total.
I'm just the type of person that I'm always going to feel a little bit vulnerable, a little bit insecure.
I mean, I wanted to clarify that I'm like a really sensitive person.
Yeah.
And it's weird when I'm not part of a group. I kind of like, it like makes me feel bad a little bit. That's just me. Like, that's how I am with groups. You know, I like to be part of the group.
I would say that Dan is socially inept in a lot of ways. I don't know if he's a former fatty or why he wasn't liked as a child, but deep down inside, he's a little kid that's seeking approval.
It's different than Fong, where I alienated myself because I didn't like those people. With you guys, it's completely opposite. It's like, all right, I really like these three.
Dan is the ultimate paranoid human being. At some point, Dan is going to be a huge liability, and unfortunately, there's nothing I can do to sort of save him from himself at this point.
Do you feel better?
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
Do you guys?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. Good.